Unbelievable face tumor people, part 6. Hello everyone, I'm Keisha, and have a great day. Millions of people become victims to real medical mysteries that go undiagnosed or misdiagnosed for years. Their lives are thrown into turmoil when giant tumors on their faces appear. Join me to meet them through this video. Are you ready? Let's begin! Number 5. Mike Koech. Mike Koech, born in 1982, living in the Republic of Kenya, had a giant tumor on his face. The tumor not only disfigured his face, but also completely damaged his left eye. It also caused Mike's nose and mouth to be tilted to one side. It is estimated that the tumor is about the size of a second head. At first, his face only had a small bump, which grew to a more terrifying level. It then ate up one side of his face, becoming so large that his nose and mouth were pushed aside, and his left eye was completely damaged. Without surgery, the doctor thought he might die from this tumor. Miracles also happened to this poor man when he was contacted by a Spanish doctor, Pedro Cavadas, who managed to take him to the Meneses Hospital in Valencia, Spain, where he was working. With his experience and his colleagues, Dr. Pedro tried everything to save Mike's life. After 4 surgeries spanning from 2011, 2013 to 2015, and finally in May 2015, Mr. Koech completely removed the tumor and brought a new face. Now, he has returned to Kenya to continue working as a motorbike taxi driver and taking care of his family. Number 4. Mohammad Latif Khatana. Mohammad Latif Khatana, born in 1980, from Kashmir, India, is also known as a faceless man due to a rare and terrible disease that causes his face to form huge lumps, eventually interferes with his ability to see, and that makes him seem like a monster to others. Born with a terrifying tumor, his face is full of extra skin folds. Over time, his tumor does not stop growing, but causes Mohammed's face to have very scary sagging wrinkles. The sagging skin covers his eyes, preventing him from seeing or working. You might think that a man like Mohammad Latif Khatana is very lonely, and you are mostly right. But fortunately, he met the woman of his life, Salima, in August 2008. Before that, Mr. Latif had many difficulties finding a wife for him. But when he met Salima, they felt like they belonged together and decided to get married. The daughter's name is Ulfat, which means love in Urdu. A baby girl weighing 2.4 kilograms was born at home in Risi district on November 10, 2012. As soon as he held the baby in his arms, Mr. Latif rushed to check if his daughter had any abnormal deformities on her body. Fortunately, baby Ulfat is completely normal. Number 3. Kiều Thị Mỹ Dung. Kiều Thị Mỹ Dung, born in 1989, is from Đà Lạt village, Xuân Thọ commune, Đà Lạt, Lâm Đồng. When Mỹ Dung was 3 months old, tumors began to appear on her face and kept growing over time, sagging into many layers covering Jung's face. According to doctors, she has a disease called neurofibromatosis, which makes her face so strange. Since birth, Jung's eyes have been uneven. At 3 months old, her face began to appear tumors, and it was constantly growing over time, sagging into many layers covering Jung's face. She also had many small tumors on her body. Especially in her arms, there were dozens of floating tumors. The largest one was the size of a thumb, and the small one was like a corn grain, and grew over time. During the past 18 months, Mi Yung has been regularly examined by doctors at Jiarui Hospital. After more than 20 years of living with a serious disease, on January 6, 2012, the surgery to remove a large tumor on the face of patient Kiều Thị Mỹ Dung was performed at Jiarui Hospital in Ho Chi Minh City with the participation of famous American surgeon McKay McKinnon. The surgery is considered a very difficult surgery because the tumor is located right on a girl's face. This is the location where many nerves are concentrated. During surgery, it is necessary not only to ensure the life of the patient, but also to ensure the patient's facial functions, such as seeing, hearing, speaking, and smelling, and ensure the aesthetics of the patient at the same time. Fortunately, it was completely successful. Number 2. Wazir Ahmad. Wazir Ahmad, a 15-month-old boy from Kapusar, Sindh province, Pakistan, had a slightly swollen nose in birth. However, soon after, due to a tumor on the child's face that began to grow rapidly, the nose completely covered Wazir's right eye and began to hang over his mouth, making it impossible for him to eat and drink normally. Wazir was born through a normal birth, but with a swollen nose. Within a few months, his nose began to grow at an unusual rate and was then the size of a cricket ball. Due to the weight and large size of the tumor, he could not eat properly. He couldn't sleep well and cried nonstop. Momo and her husband, Gulab Bai, took their children to several doctors, but no one could help. They took him to a private clinic, where doctors advised him that he needed immediate surgery to remove the growth. However, the local doctors could not help the boy. Obviously, they don't have enough expertise or experience because this disease is so rare. Parents suffer from extreme poverty. The father pointed out that they could not afford treatment. They could only pray to God that some miracle would happen. Later, the chief of staff of the Pakistan People's Party, Bilawal Bhutto Zardari, heard about Wazir's case and sent a car to take the family to a larger hospital in Karachi. Number 1. Daima Mengorio. Daima Mengorio of Pakistan was born with a relatively large bump on his nose. A giant tumor, the size of a tennis ball, grew between his eyebrows, pressing his nose and blocking his right eye, causing pain and discomfort. Initially, he had a small tumor, the size of a ring pearl on his nose, but over time, it grew so large that it covered his eyes. Doctors explained that Daima's neural tube developed abnormally during fetal life, leading to cracks in the skull and the brain growing out of the skull from the cracks. This condition, known as encephalocele, is a congenital condition that occurs due to the immature formation of nerve cells in the fetus. Surgery is the only way to save and continue this child's life, but there is a chance he will lose his sight. Daima's parents are not rich. They are even facing economic difficulties. However, they spent all their savings on treating their child, including what they had planned for their eldest daughter's wedding. But because the child is so young, the doctors will only perform surgery if his condition is assured, and when all reports are positive. In the meantime, the doctor suggested his diet to improve his health. There are also many successful surgeries in the world when the patient is healthy enough. Hopefully, Daima will always have good luck. Those are extremely pitiful people. They are born with a difference in appearance. It even causes an extremely painful feeling, but they are strong enough to overcome it. God will protect them. Thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification bell to watch more interesting videos. And now, goodbye and see you again.